Welcome to the final season of the Sprite Cup Series. We're live at Charlotte Motor Speedway for the Coca-Cola 600, the 20-lap endurance race. It's a beautiful night for racing. Let's take a look at your drivers to watch for. Josh Berry starts on pole for tonight's race. He's hoping to make a statement here tonight. Hendrick Motorsports has dominated the Coke 600 the last few years. They won four straight, and their streak was broken last year when Kyle Busch in a RCR car won it. Chase Elliott is the only HMS driver currently that does not have a Coke 600 win under his belt. He starts on the outside pole tonight, and he hopes to get it done. Brad Keselowski was in contention for the win last week at Las Vegas, tangled with Denny Hamlin on the final lap, allowing Ty Gibbs to sneak by and steal the win. As stated earlier, Kyle Busch won this race last year. He's hoping for two straight this year. Martin Truex Jr. wrecked out last week at Las Vegas while battling for the lead with Ross Chastain. He hopes to correct that tonight. Ty Gibbs, last week's winner, comes into tonight as the points leader. He starts pretty deep in the field tonight. He hopes to make up some positions so we can maintain that points lead. Now let's go trackside for the command.
Gentlemen, start your engines!
Cars fired up and roll off for 20 laps around this mile and a half speedway. Now let's look at your starting lineup. On the pole is Josh Berry, and to his outside is Chase Elliott. Behind them, it's Kyle Larson and Noah Gragson. Then we have Brad Keselowski and Ryan Blaney. And it's Chris Buescher and Christopher Bell, a pair of Chris's in row 4. And then in row 5, it's Joey Logano and Eric Jones. We have John Hunter Nemechek and William Byron. Behind them, it's Chase Briscoe and Kyle Busch. And we have Austin Cindric and Martin Truex Jr. Behind them, it's Ty Gibbs and Harrison Burton. And we have Austin Dillon and Ryan Preece. Behind them, Ross Chastain and Bubba Wallace. And it's Daniel Suarez and Denny Hamlin. And running out the field, it is Alex Bowman. We're ready for 20 laps of hard racing here in the Queen City. Race car pulls off. Green flag is out in the air. We're racing at Charlotte. Three wide for the lead as Kyle Larson takes second away from Berry. Chase Elliott takes the lead as here they come in lap 2. Barry now to the inside of Larson is trying to take the lead away. Oh, and he goes around and into the wall. Caution is out. The 4 of Josh Berry spinning towards the inside wall. Hits it not once, but twice. Let's take a look at what happened. Oh, looks like he made contact with Kyle Larson. That sent him spinning down to the inside. Hits the wall not once, but twice. Tough break for the pole sitter. He was running third, hoping to take second from Larson, and it went wrong. Tough break for him. He's out of the race early. We're ready to restart on lap 5 out of 20 here in the Coke 600. Chase Elliott will be our leader for this next restart. Green flag is back out. Elliott easily able to clear Larson there on the restart. Here comes Noah Dragon to the inside to take third away from Ryan Blaney, or try to take third away. Meanwhile, Larson working on trying to take the lead away from Chase Elliott. Here comes to the inside. Can't quite make the pass. Elliott maintains the lead for the moment. Meanwhile, further back, they're three wide for fourth place. Christopher Bell, Brad Kozlowski, and Noah Gregson. A lot of jockeying for position back there behind these leaders, as Christopher Bell now takes third away from Ryan Blaney. Oh, and he goes around! Back up across the track! Collects a bunch of them! Caution is back out. The 20 of Christopher Bell racing defensively against Ryan Blaney spins in turn 3, comes back up across the track, and collects innocent bystanders Noah Gregson and Brad Kozlowski. Let's take a look at what happened. Coming down the backstretch, Ryan Blaney with a run tries to pass Christopher Bell. Bell blocks and just turns himself off the nose of Ryan Blaney. Spins, comes back up across the track and collects Noah Gregson and Brad Kozlowski. Nowhere to go for those two. Innocent bystanders in that ordeal. That's a tough break for all three of them. They're out of the race. We're ready to restart with 10 laps to go here in the Coke 600. Chase Elliott will once again be your leader for this next restart. Green flag is back out. Larson utilizing the outside line, trying to take the lead away from Chase Elliott. As Blaney now takes second away from Kyle Larson, here comes William Byron to take third away. And now here comes Byron on the inside of Blaney to take that second spot. Elliott still maintains the lead through all of this. Now Larson will try to work on trying to take that third spot away from Ryan Blaney. As Elliott continues to parade the field around Charlie, here comes Larson to the inside of Blaney now to take that third position. Hendrick top three now. Elliott, Byron, Larson. They all take different lines through 3 and 4, as now Larson takes second away from Byron. Now he'll work on trying to take the lead away from Chase Elliott. Again, they take different lines and they bump into each other. Three wide for the lead between the Hendrick boys. And back in the pack. Crash between Ross Chastain and Martin Truex Jr. again. Shades of last week at Las Vegas. Caution is out. The one of Ross Chastain. Heavy damage to that car. So too the 19 of Martin Truex Jr. Deja vu. What are the odds? Let's take a look at what happened. To the right of your screen, you'll see the 19 and the 1. Oh, it looks like the 1 just got in the back of 19, got in the back of the 19, got him loose, and then 19 spun down in front of the 1. 1 hits him. They both go up into the wall. Tough breaks for both of them. This will be the end of their night. We're ready to restart with 2 laps to go here in the Coke 600. Chase Elliott has led all the laps so far tonight. Will these guys have anything for him? Let's find out. Green flag is back out. Larson with a great push to his teammate. Able to... Oh, and they wreck behind! Massive crash on the restart. And just like that, the caution is back out. And that will mean we will go to overtime. The 24 of William Byron wrecked. Tonight won't be a second Coke 600 for him. Joey Logano, heavy damage to the nose. Ty Gibbs, the point leader, wrecked. Kyle Larson was having such a great night running up at the front. He's up against the wall, along with Ryan Blaney, who was also having a really great night battling for those top spots. And Kyle Busch, it won't be two in a row for him tonight. Red flag situation here at Charlotte. The field has been stopped just shy of the start-finish line as we try to get this mess sorted out. What happened? Larson pushing Elliott, and then Gibbs makes it three wide going into turn one. Oh, looks like he thought he was clear, came up on the five, turned himself. And that's what starts this whole mess. Let's take a look at it again. Watch the green 54, bottom left of your screen. Goes to the inside of the five, moves up, must have thought he was clear, tags the 24, and then 24 is T-boned by the 22. That's what gave him that nose damage. '54 crashes with the 5. Who crashes with the 12. And then the 8 piles in. As well. 6 cars involved in this one. Here at Charlotte. Big cleanup. Tough break for all of these guys. They're all out of the race. And now the red flag has been lifted. We're back under yellow flag condition. We're ready to restart in overtime. Remember, it's a 2-lap shootout. If the leader takes the white flag under green, then the next flag ends the race, either the caution or the checkered. If a caution comes out before the leader can get to the white flag, then we'll line them up and we'll do it again. We can be here all night if we have to. Unlimited attempts at a restart. Chase Elliott has led all the laps so far tonight. He'll restart alongside Daniel Suarez at the drop of the green flag. Green flag is back out. We're in overtime. 99 able to keep up with the 9. Now the 9 clears them going into turn 3. Here comes the 99 to the inside of the 9. They take the white flag. 99 can't quite make the pass. Elliott maintains the lead. He's down the back stretch for the final time. Here comes Suarez to the outside of Elliott. Back across the front stretch. Chase Elliott's going to hold him off. And he'll win the Coke 600. A masterclass by Chase Elliott. Holding off the 99 to Daniel Suarez and takes the checkered flag here on the Coke 600. He'll burn it down here at Charlotte. Congratulations to Chase Elliott for winning the Coca-Cola 600 at Charlotte. Here are your final results. Chase Elliott takes the win in the Coke 600. Daniel Suarez coming in a close second. That was a great battle between them for the win on that last restart. Alex Bowman coming home third after starting dead last. Great, great result for him. Hamlin finishing fourth after starting 24th. Bubba Wallace rounds out the top five. Chris Buescher, Olsen Cindric, Ryan Preece, Chase Briscoe, Austin Dillon, rounding out the top 10. 11th and 12th for the Legacy Motor Club camp. Harrison Burton finishes as the last car on track. And from William Byron on down are the DNFs. Half the field wrecked out in this race. And here are your point standings after tonight. Chase Elliott, with this win, moves up to the points lead. Bubba Wallace takes over second, just 1 point behind the leader. Gibbs falls down to third with his wreck with two to go. Buescher up to fifth. Keselowski now down to sixth after his wreck tonight. Still a lot of jostling in the standings, as it's still early in the season. But as the season progresses, these point standings will become more static. As it stands now, Noah Gregson is last in points. Next week, we're staying in the state of North Carolina. We'll be heading to Rockingham. Last time we were here was for the Christmas All-Star Race. And it gets a points-paying date in the final season of the Sprite Cup Series. That should be great nostalgia for a lot of NASCAR fans. I hope you enjoyed this race. This is Harvick 99 in the booth, signing off.